So Yoda first made his appearance in the 1980s in Star Wars. Of course, he was the guide, the mentor, the teacher of all the other Jedi. He's also who many people consider to be the most emotionally intelligent character who's ever been created. I mean, I suppose he should be, after all, he's 900 years old. Yoda is about the skill of emotional intelligence. Now, the business leaders I interviewed specifically identified two aspects of emotional intelligence: empathy and self-awareness. Empathy is about being able to put yourself into somebody else's shoes, to see things the way they see things. This is in stark contrast to what we have in a lot of organizations, which is sympathy. Sympathy means that you say you're sorry, and we get told I'm sorry all the time. You call a 1-800 number, the first thing that somebody says on the phone is, I'm sorry you're going through that. You check in late for a flight, you miss a plane, I'm sorry. We get told I'm sorry all the time. We also get told I'm sorry all the time by coworkers, by peers, by leaders. It is not about being sorry. It is about literally thinking about a time when you felt the way, or when you were in a similar situation that that other person was in, and thinking about how you felt. Putting yourself into somebody else's shoes. Seeing things the way they see things. This is crucial because this is where psychological safety and trust and all that humanness comes from. It's when people believe and understand that they can connect with you. They don't connect with you when you say, I'm sorry. They connect with you when you say, you know what? I was in a similar situation like that. I know exactly how you feel. That's the connection. Big difference. Empathy is about understanding how somebody else feels. Then we have self-awareness. I interviewed Dr. Tasha Urich, who's probably the world's leading expert on self-awareness. And she wrote a fantastic book on this, and she identifies two components of self-awareness: the internal side and the external side. The internal side is, how well do you know yourself? Do you know your own strengths? Do you know your own weaknesses? Do you know what motivates you? Do you know what excites you? Do you know what zaps your energy? Do you know what depresses you or stresses you out? That's the internal side. The external side is, do other people know that about you? Do other people know your strengths and weaknesses? If you asked one of your peers, hey, do you know what really motivates me as a leader? Would they be able to answer that question? Or if you ask them, do you know what really zaps my energy or really just like what makes me feel bad and down and depressed at work? Would they be able to answer that? That's the external side of self-awareness. Now, according to Dr. Tasha Urich's research, 95% of people around the world believe they are self-aware. Only 15% are. The scary statistic is that the more senior you become, the less self-aware you become. And when I say senior, I'm not talking about age. I'm talking about the more senior you become in your company, the less self-aware you become, the more removed you become from what's happening inside of your company. Empathy and self-awareness. Again, you can practice simple things. Next time somebody comes to you with a problem, don't just respond and say, I'm sorry. Just take a minute. Listen to what they're telling you. And try to think if you have ever been in that kind of a similar situation and how you felt. And try to make yourself feel that same way. Whether you're talking to a customer, whether you're talking to an employee, whether you're talking to a coworker, another leader, it doesn't matter. Self-awareness. Again, ask yourself these very basic questions. And you can even ask your coworkers, your peers, these same questions. I did an executive workshop once for a large consumer packaged goods company. And they had all the leaders in the room. And we did this workshop where all the leaders wrote down what they thought their strengths and weaknesses were and what they thought motivated them and zapped their energy. And then they paired up with somebody else in the room. And that other person in the room had to answer those same questions about the leader. And then they talked together for 10 minutes. All you could hear is just laughter. People were so far off the mark, it was amazing. They had no idea that other people viewed them these ways. They had no idea that leaders viewed themselves these ways. So you need to make sure that you can create that internal and external self-awareness. David Meek is the CEO of Ipsen, a pharmaceutical company around 6,000 employees. I loved his quote. And he said, I've never had lunch with technology, have you? I would take an emotionally intelligent person over a piece of software any time. The emotional intelligence piece is essential.